اس کو شفیع جو میرا غاس ہے اور لاڈلا بیٹا تیرا.
Number 9, if a man doesn't have a full fist, is he allowed to do jama'ah? Tia, do you pray behind?
Adhan, Adhan and
Jama'ah. Adhan, Jama'ah, Naj Sharif Salah. So the hukum in regards to a person who is a fasiq, fasiq mu'min, an open sinner, and I think we need it finished. I'm sorry, how much time have I taken? A fasiq mu'min is an open sinner. And a person who openly sins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dislikes that type of person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not like a person who openly sins because he is shameless. Be sharam hai na, jo khule aam gunah kare, Allah ki nafarmani. A person who hides and sins is a lot better than he who openly sins. Jo chup kar gunah kare, usse fasiq ghair mu'min kehte hain. اور اس کے پیچھے نماز بھی جائز ہے. اور فاسق مولن جو کھلے عام گناہ کرے اس کے پیچھے نماز جائز نہیں ہے. Because the person who is leading the namaz is your wasila to reach Allah. And you are making a person who Allah is displeased with as an imam. Specifically talking about the beard, though, this is how displeasing it is. Two men from one of the kings in the time of the Prophet Muhammad صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم. It was either Qaisar or Kisra, Najashi ke do aadmi, pata nahi. Two of one of the non-believing kings, two men of one of the non-believing kings came with a message from their king to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And they came and they had big mustaches, they had clean shaven beard. Okay? And they came and sat in front of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam turned his face away. He turned his blessed face away and he refused to look at them. Even though کہ یا رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم یہ تو مسلمان نہیں ہے, they are not Muslims, they are not bound by the law that they have to lengthen their beard, but still the Prophet صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم just disliked that look of no beard so much in a man that he refused to look at them. ٹھیک ہے, and therefore you can understand how displeasing it is to the Prophet Muhammad صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم, and whatever is displeasing to the Prophet Muhammad صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم is displeasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore I make dua that Allah gives us all the tawfiq to make sure that we lengthen our beard and we protect it from decreasing it and shaving it. Now, if a person of such needs the namaz in imamat, so the ulama kiram says that what more respect can a person give to another then make him the imam of his namaz. Remember when Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu was made the imam of the Sahaba, they said, what greater position could the Prophet give, and what greater sign could the Prophet give that he is the first Ali? Because that is such an important matter. And Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu himself said, the person whom Allah's Messenger appointed for our matters of deen, yani namaz, we appoint him for our matters of the dunya. Tiha, yani we make him the Khalifa as well. That's how important the Imam of the Masjid is. He is your wasila to reach Allah. And the Prophet said, إِذَا مُدِحَ الْفَاسِقِ, when a fasiq is given a praiseworthy position or he is praised, جب اس کی مدح کی جائے غضب الرب, تو the Lord becomes angry. رب تعالی غصے ہو جاتا ہے, اللہ غضبناک ہو جاتا ہے. وَحْتَزَّ بِهِ الْعَرْشِ, and due to it, or ek riwayat mein wahtaz lahu al-arsh, and because of it the arsh starts to shake. Theek hai, Mufti Azam Hind Alai Rahma in his fatawa mustafaviya, in a question like this he writes this, ke dari jiski ek mush se kam kaatta ho, jiski ek mush se kam ho uske piche namaz pad sakte hai, hai na, jo ek mush se kam kaatta ho uske piche nahi pad sakte, samajh mein aayi na bhai? Yani ek mush se kam agar kisi ki abhi nikli nahi hai, ابھی نکل رہی ہے, وہ کاٹا کبھی نہیں ہے یا اس کی نکلتی ہی نہیں. I have a uncle, میرے تایا ہے, my dad's eldest brother, he is a great hafiz, he is known as Khair al-Huffaz, hundreds of hafiz are his students all over the UK. Many places I go to, I went to Dudley and I found students of it, and he doesn't have a beard, clean, because his beard doesn't grow. He has no hair on his head, no eyebrows, no mustache, no eyelash. I don't know if he's got eyelashes. I don't think he has eyelashes. So. But that's the situation. So people like that, you can pray namaz behind him. He's not a fasik. And mashallah, may Allah give him a long life. He used to, in them days, when they came into the UK, a Tablighi group came into the Masjid al-Razak in Preston, and he was one of the first people involved in this Masjid al-Razak. And under his guidance, the rest of them, they threw the bags of the Tablighis out and they told them, this is a Masjid of Imam Ahmad. Yes. I'm talking probably 1970s or even before that. That's how old. And people later used to think, this is wrong. Now the people of Harrow know that that was right. Yeah. Even the people of Gloucester, who are the true Sunni Sayyid Aqidah, will think, yahi karna hai, if you don't do that, to phir kya hoga? And I think in Gloucester, they did try to get rid of them, but they just couldn't. Because when you have within yourselves people who have a naram dili towards the Devbandis, then you've got hamari kashti waha dubi jaha pani kam tha. Ek shair ne kaha hai, shair has said, ki dushman to dushman hame to apno ne luta. Dushman to dushman hai, hame to apno ne luta, hamari kashti waha dubi jaha pani kam tha. The boat should have drowned where there was so much water, but it drowned where there was less water. Why? Because apno hi mein kharab. And that's the situation, that when you have people amongst you who have been exploited, or they have given up, then you will. It's easy for them to infiltrate. To khair, dari ek musht wajib hai. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's hukum is for wujub. Whatever the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam orders, then it becomes wajib. Al amru lil wujub. This is in usul fiqh. Koi bhi par sakta. In all the fuqaha kiram, they all agree with that. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gives an order, it is wajib to follow. Usko uski itiba wajib hai. Theek hai? Depending on its strength of evidence. So if it's mutawatir, tab to farz ho jayega. Sahaba kiram ke zamane mein, they had to. It was farz for them when the order was there. And for us, al amru lil wujub, the hukum of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam proves something to be farz or wajib. It becomes necessary and obligatory upon us to follow. When he says, lengthen your beard, okay, is that a hukum or is it not a hukum? A'fu al-luha. So, huwana hukum hai, fa'li amra hai. So, it's wajib to lengthen your beard. Dari ko banana wajib ho gaya. Ab wahabi kehte hai ki ab banate jao. Hukum a gaya, badhao to badhao. Theek hai? That's why you see wahabis make long beard. Theek hai? Because if the Prophet ﷺ has given the hukum, then it's become wajib now. And he said, ke muncho ko ghatao, and lessen your mustache. There is also a narration where it says, shave your mustache, completely remove it. Both are narrated. Kam karo, puri nikalo, dono hai. Mufti Azam Ehind al-Rama used to prefer not to shave it, because the Wahhabis tend to do that a lot. So that's why he preferred not to. And I also prefer not to. And so the Prophet ﷺ's order. So when the mustache hair comes to over the lips, the ulama say ke ab wajib hai kaato. Theek hai? Kyunki hukum hai na, kam karo, hukum hai. To ab ye bhi to hukum hai ke badhao dahi ko, to ye bhi wajib hua. To wajib to ho gaya. Ab kitni badhaye, hai na? How much shall be lengthened? Isko ab yu samjhe ke Quran Sharif mein Allah ne farmaya, wamsahu bi ru'usikum. Wuzu ke baare mein, ke when you do wuzu, to saro ka masah karo. Theek hai? Saroka masakaro. Now, biru usikum, to the ba in the Arabic language is tabildiya, yani baz sarka masakaro. To baz ka masakaro, to kitna masakare? How much shall we do? The Imam Malik ne kaha ki ba istiyab ke liye hai. Istiyab means the whole. The Imam Malik kehte pure sarka masakaro. If somebody leads a maliki in namaz and he just does 1/4 of his head, the maliki ki namaz nahi hogi uske piche. Because according to Imam Malik, fam sahu bi usikum, pure sar ka masah karo. Theek hai? To aise hi, not like this, obviously Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal is on another level, of course. Wahhabi log kehte hai ki hum daadi badhate jao. Puri badhao, jitni badhe badhti jaye. Theek hai? Now, we have a hadith, Quran ki ayat mein to hai ki sadke hisse ka masakib kitna karo ye nahi maloom. To ab ek khabre wahid, a single narration of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that he masaha bi nasiyatihi, he did masa of one quarter of his head. So isse, this hadith joins with this verse of the Quran and it explains ke masa karne ka jo farz hai wo ek chauthai hai, ek chauthai sar ka masa karo. Theek hai, Imam Malik kehte hain radhiyallahu ta'ala ke Quran ki ayat ko khabre wahid se badla nahi ja sakta. That's why they don't accept that, they just say pure sar ka masa, samajh mein aaya? To hadith mein bhi this is exactly the same situation. Waha the miqdar was mujmal, yani it was ambiguous how much masa, in here how much we lengthen, ye mujmal hai. Sarkar ne farma diya dari ko bada, kitni bada ho ye mujmal hai, it's ambiguous. To ek riwayat milti hai Bukhari Sharif mein Hazrat Abdullah ibn Umar radhiyallahu anhu ke bare mein ke Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Umar radhiyallahu anhu, aur ye hai sahabi rasool, theek hai? Aur hamari fiqh mein, in the usul of fiqh, it is proven that an action of a sahabi is enough to prove something to be permissible. Sahabi ne kuch kar liya to wo jaiz ho gaya, theek hai? If a sahabi did something, it's permissible. So there's a hadith ke Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Umar radhiyallahu anhu either did Hajj or he did Umrah. Ikhtilaf hai riwayat mein. Hajj kiya ya Umrah kiya, and then he held his beard in his fist and he cut off what was below it. Ek qubda. Hai na? So the hukum is wajib ke dhari ko badhate jao, kaatna na jaiz hai. You can't cut it, it's not permissible. But Hazrat Abdullah ibn Umar ne ek musht ke baad kaata, to ek musht ke baad kaatna jaiz hua. Samajh mein aa gayi baat? So after one fist, it is permissible to cut it. Now, if you don't accept this hadith, like the Wahhabis, they just lengthen it. If you believe the beard should be slightly shorter than one fist, to aap dikhaye kahan jaiz hai. Aapko ye riwayat dikhaya hume. Show us a narration which says ke less than a fist katna jaiz hai, kisi sahabi ne kiya ho. Based on the usul of fiqh, theek hai? Aur Hazrat Ibn Hajar Asqalani radiyallahu anhu aur unke bhi ilawa fuqaha kiram ne farmaya ke where do you measure the beard from, the farmaya min asfali dhakr, from the lowest part of the chin, theek hai? To Tahir al-Qazi kehta hai yahan se napo, yahan se. To Allama Ibn Hajar Asqalani kehte hai from the lowest part of the chin. To ab aap kiski baat manenge? Allama Ibn Hajar Asqalani ki baat mane, fuqaha Hanafiya ne bhi likha hai, ab us se theek hai, samajh mein aa rahi hai baat? Now in the Quran the word qubda has been used, qabda, where Hazrat Musa alayhi salam held the beard of Sayyidina Harun alayhi salam in his fist. If it was less than a fist, then it's, you can't hold it in the fist. And that is a supporting evidence to show ke jo khaslat thi anbiya ikram ki, the khaslat of the anbiya was to have a one fist beard. Theek hai? So the beard, one fist is wajib. The proof is quite clear in the Hanafi fiqh. There is a Ghulam Rasul Sayyidi Saab, a very, very big scholar who has written extensively on this issue, where he's talked about the beard not being wajib, one fist. And he said the first was Imam Ahmad Raza or Sheikh Abdullah Muhaddis Adani to say it's wajib. The truth is, he is mistaken. In the books of Durr-e Mukhtar of Allama Imam Haskafi radiallahu anhu, he clearly says, to cut it less than one fist, lam yubihu ahadun, kisi ne bhi jaiz nahi kaha. Nobody has said it is permissible to cut the beard less than one fist. Theek hai? So if it's not permissible, that means it is wajib. Yani sabne wajib kaha hai, aapko nazar nahi aaya, aapko sirf Ala Hazrat ki ibadat se samajh mein aaya. Halanki it is clear, they all said it's wajib. But then he has quoted many scholars who have said ke sunnat hai, sunnat hai, sunnat hai. Theek hai? Ek musht sunnat hai. And wallahi lazim, maine khud ibarat dekhi, I've seen the text myself, and you know, and it's very astonishing for me to find that a great scholar can be mistaken such. That the text actually says that after one fist, it is sunnat to cut. Samajh mein aayi baat? Ye nahi likha hai ke ek musht sunnat hai. Ye likha hai ke ek musht hone ke baad kaatna sunnat hai. So he's completely misunderstood the text. Theek hai? To ek musht ke baad daadi ko kaatna sunnat hai, and that's why some of the Hanafi scholars have said to leave it more than a fist is disliked. Khilafi ulama ne kaha makruh hai. Some have said it's fine. Theek hai banaye. So the best opinion in that is that once it reaches a fist, you should cut it. Theek hai? When Sayyidina Quhafa, Abu Quhafa radiallahu anhu, the father of Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he accepted Iman. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, how good would it be if you took from the width and the length of your beard? Yani dadi ko aisi rakho ke log dekhi to khubsurat lage. Samajh mein aayi na? And remember, it's in the length that one fist is wajib, not in the width. So ab koi kahe ke yahan bhi ek musht honi chahiye, yahan bhi ek musht, ye nahi hai. Ye zyaadti hai. Theek hai? Ek musht lambai honi chahiye. Theek hai? To aise peer bhi peer nahi hai, because it's one of the conditions of being a peer that he should not be a fasik, not an open sinner. Aise imam ke piche namaz padhna ghazab ilahi ka mujib hai. It causes the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is makruh tahrimi to perform that namaz, wajib ul-yada. It is wajib for you to repeat such a namaz. ठीक है
और वो बंदा अज़ान दे सकता
है अच्छा last question after this अज़ान of a fasiq is also not permissible ठीक है because remember fasiq मोलिन जो खुलेआम गुनाह करे तो उसकी अज़ान भी जायज नहीं है ठीक है if he gives अज़ान तो the अज़ान should be repeated ठीक है वो इकामत कहे तो उसकी इकामत भी फिर से करे वो नमाज पढ़ाए तो वो नमाज भी फिर से पढ़े ठीक है That's the hukum in the Hanafi fiqh. And Naat Sharif bhi padhne ke baare mein hai ke uski Naat Sharif bhi na suni jaye. Samajh mein aayega? Even a Naat Kha who cuts his beard less than a fist, Ala Hazrat ne saaf likha hai, and not from himself. And as Ala Hazrat always did, Dalail ka ambar laga dete. He has proven from the Hanafi fiqh that it is not permissible to listen to Naat Sharif, Azan, Quran ki tilawat, from a fasiq mu'lim. And I'll explain to you why that is. Because he quotes the Hanafi Fuqaha Kiram where they have clearly said ke ihanatul fasiqi wajibun. Ke fasiq ki ihanat wajib hai. Samajh mein aayi baat? Yani a person who is an open sinner, you must disrespect him. You must show disrespect for towards him. Theek hai? Uski ta'zim jaiz nahi hai. You can't show respect to a fasiq mu'lim who openly commits sin. And then Ala Hazrat Adiyallahu says ke jo aadmi imamat karaye uski taazim wajib hai jo aadmi quran ki tilawat kare uski taazim wajib hai jo aadmi mustafa ki naat padhe uski taazim wajib hai jo aadmi azan padhe uski taazim wajib hai jo aadmi iqamat kare uski taazim wajib hai to ab ye naat pad raha hai to taazim wajib hai lekin fasik mu'min hai ihanat wajib hai is wajah se ulama ne kaha کہ ایسے نعت خانوں کی نعت سننا ناجائز وہ اپنے آپ میں اکیلے اکیلے جو چاہے پڑھتے رہے لیکن عوام کے سامنے اس کی نعت نہیں سننی چاہیے ایسے نعت خانوں کو بلانا بھی نہیں چاہیے and I really really blame the mosque committees and the people who organize events who invite such نعت خانس ان کو نہیں بلانا چاہیے آپ سوچیں کہ if a man stops you when you're driving at 30 miles per hour He stops you, flashes his light and flashes you down. You stop. You come out. And he's wearing shorts and a t-shirt and he says, you're doing 35 miles per hour. I'm arresting you. He'd be like, who are you to arrest me? I'm a police officer. How can I believe you're a police officer? You've not got a uniform. Because there has to be a uniform for us to recognize a person as a specific, as a professional in a specific field. A doctor, same thing. Where's your uniform? Somebody comes to do some plumbing work. Where's your ID? In the same way, when a person stands up to pray naat and praise the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the uniform is your beard. है ना? जब सूट टाई पहन करके आप नाते मुस्तफा पढ़ रहे हो, गले में ईसाई का फंडा, the cross, और नात शरीफ पढ़ रहे हो, तो कौन सी बात हुई है ना? तो there has to be a uniform. कोई आदमी आके कहे कि मैं फतवा देता हूँ, मैं आलिम हूँ, भाई तुम्हारा uniform कहाँ है? तुम तो सूट टाई पहने हो, or you're in shorts, माज़ाल्लाह. Even your satr is not covered. To koi alim ho in the time of Sayyidina Imam Abu Yusuf radiallahu anhu, when he became the Qazi al-Quzat, the student of Imam Azam Abu Hanifa, he ordered all the fuqaha kiram in Kufa that they must wear everything black. Kala Imam Sharif, kala jubba. Ye jaise coat ki tarah jubba pehna hai, kala ho, اور امام ابی جبا اندر لباس سفید ہو کوئی عرض نہیں. ٹھیک ہے, وائی ڈیڈ ہی ڈو دس؟ تاکہ لوگ جانے کہ یہ فقیہ جا رہا ہے. ہے نا, کسی کو مسئلہ پوچھنا ہے تو پوچھے اس سے کہ یہ دین کا ایک فقیہ جا رہا ہے. اور کوئی آدمی فقیر کی طرح رہے تو اب اس کو کیسے لوگ فقیر سمجھے؟ حالانکہ دیرو اولیاء کرام ہے, اولیاء کرام ہے who live a فقیرانہ لائف. But as Ala Hazrat رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ said, that those people who are working for the deen in the میدان are superior than those who are in the jungles living a life of فقیر. ہے نا, وہ جو میدان میں آ کر دین کی تبلیغ کر رہا وہ اس سے افضل ہے جو جنگلوں میں اللہ کی یاد میں تنہا ہو چکا ہے. ٹھیک ہے, بیکاز ہی از فالوئنگ دا سنت آف پروفیٹ محمد صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم. تو اس وجہ سے یونیفارم ہوتا ہے, نعت خواں آئے تو داڑھی دیکھے, لباس دیکھے, سب صحیح ہو تب اس کی نعت شریف سنے. ٹھیک ہے, any more questions? The questions are, I think,
kuch log daadi rakha de, sirf face laga de, karte chote chote rakhte hai usko,
isliye ha ek mush se kam kaatna najayiz hai. If you cut it less than a fist is not permissible. So if somebody has kept a beard but it's not reached one fist length, you shouldn't say ke are kya fayda rakhne se, mat rakho ye wo. Kam se kam raste mein hai na, to encourage people like that, hai na, unko thoda hausla de ke aur bhai مدینہ شریف کے آدھے راستے پہنچ چکے ہو, اور آگے چلو, کیوں یہاں رک چکے ہو, ہے نا, اور آگے چلو. یہ اس طرح ان کو کچھ انکریجمنٹ دے.